All right, well, paper two is definitely the hardest one. It's the longest one as well. It's kind of like a grind. It's 2.5 or 2 hours and 15 minutes long, and it's done right after paper one. Now this one is definitely an endurance factor, but I have some suggestions on how you can do well on it. It's also worth a little bit more than the other ones too. I think it's 30% instead of 25 percent of your score. But it's very similar to paper one that it covers all the topics, all the main topics, except you have to show your work for it. And they give you these little boxes to kind of show your work. And the real test is actually like much bigger than this. They give you a lot more space. I just kind of condensed it down to save some space. But anyway, kind of going step by step, they usually ask you 9 to 10 short answer questions. Now, like when I say short answer, it's usually like an A, B, and C, something like this. This is question one, for example. This is still question one. Question one. Then it goes to question two. Now, like when it's question one, it's all about the same scenario. Question two is all about this same circuit. Question three is about this circuit. Question four, is about some. So when they ask you, when I mean different questions, it means different scenarios. And they try to ask you a variety of questions about different topics about that same scenario. So let's kind of go through an example. This example paper has 9 questions in it. Some of them have 10. This is a little bit shorter questions, but usually between 9 and 10 questions are asked. And they actually have two copies here, two different versions. So I can go through both of them with you. But anyway, so for example, this first example. Question one is about something being fired in the air and then it lands back down here. So they ask you a question about Suvat. Then they go about forces. Then they go conceptual question. Then they go about thermodynamics. Then conceptual question about thermodynamics. Then they go into some graphical analysis, kind of like back to mechanics again. And then they talk a little bit about fluid dynamics. What about air resistance? Fluid dynamics is very, very minor topic in IB, but it is there every once in a while. So look at this first question. Within it, they try to cover the first couple topics here. If you think about the first three topics here, it's about uncertainties, graphs, measurement, mechanics, and thermodynamics. And within this first question, they had mechanics. Then they went into thermal, then they went into graphs, and then a little bit of fluids. But fluids is just an extension of mechanics. So, like this first topic, kind of tried to hit the first three concepts in the formula packet. So they try to go in order as well on paper two, but it's a little bit more open-ended. They might jump around a little bit more. Let's look at the question two here. Question two is about a circuit. So they ask you some stuff about just figure out stuff about the circuit. In fact, a lot of these questions about circuits. So let's go through the annotated thing. So it looks like they kind of skipped the wave stuff and went to circuits. So all the next questions about circuits. Then they asked a question about another circuit. So here's a hint about paper two. If they ask you a question about circuits or a specific topic, later on in the test, they're going to ask you a similar question about that same topic, but at the higher level. Here's the way the formula packet works is it goes through all the standard level stuff first, and then it asks you about the higher level stuff about the same topic. So if you go in order, there's mechanics, then there's thermodynamics, then there's waves, then there's circuits and magnetism. Then there's circular motion and gravitation. Then there's particle physics, real basic particle physics stuff. Then there's kind of like some higher level thermodynamics, about energy. This is like the albedo stuff and like the black body radiation and some stuff about energy stuff. Then it goes to higher level waves before those beginning levels. And then it goes to, there's a lot of stuff for higher level waves. Then it goes to higher level fields with the circular motion stuff. Then it goes into higher level electricity. Then it goes into higher level particle physics. Then it go options is that's a paper three, so don't worry about that until paper three. But anyway, so it becomes a lot more complex. So if you see a question about a circuit, and then the next question is about a circuit, you know that this is going to be the standard level, the first stuff, and this is going to be the higher level stuff. So the way you can go through it is like, oh, this is a question about a circuit. It must be about this kind of stuff. Oh, there's another question about a circuit. Let's go to the higher level stuff, really advanced higher level. Oh, that's going to be, oh, this is wave stuff. So let's go to, this is circuit of motion and fields. Okay. Oh, here's electricity and circuits. This is the higher level circuit stuff. So they kind of split it up that way. It's going to go through here. Here's some wave stuff. We haven't covered any wave stuff yet in this paper, so it's going to be the basic wave stuff. So they'll try to ask you a basic wave stuff question first. So if you scroll up, they skip to waves. So they're going to come back to it. And then they go into, do they do a higher level wave? Oh, and then they go into energy production and nuclear stuff. Well, they haven't asked a question about that yet, so they'll, if you go through here, so they try to cover the standard level stuff first and then do the higher level stuff, but they sometimes jump around. So it's gonna be in here. That's gonna be where you can find that answer. And then here's, oh, now there's another question about nuclear stuff. This must be under the higher level concepts. This is gonna be on, oh, this is going to be under Newton's law of gravitation, which is the basic circular motion stuff. Now, ooh, this one has another electricity and waves, so they try to combine waves and electricity into one in this one. But here it's going to be the higher level electricity because they already asked the electricity question, and the higher level wave stuff because they didn't ask a higher level wave stuff yet. That's kind of the trick to this paper too. That's why it's so hard to do well on it because it does jump around a lot more. You do have to navigate through the formula packet a lot more and be familiar with the equations. But it's going to do that same thing. It's going to ask you about two or three questions about each major topic for each paper. And this one's also probably the most unpredictable paper. Some years it's very straightforward, some years it's really random. Some years they focus heavily on particle physics, some years they focus heavily on like black body radiation, some years they focus heavily on waves. It really is random. Let's look at another example here for paper two. So they start off with mechanics, and then they ask a question about temperature. Which is their own thermodynamics in here. They still want some circular motion. So some like entry level mechanics, entry level thermal, entry level circular motion, a little bit more mechanics. And then they go to question two. So right there in this second version, they covered the entry level mechanics, which is this stuff. They covered the entry level thermal, which is this stuff, and they covered up to entry level circular motion. So you can kind of like cross that off your list. If you're taking this test, you can kind of like put a check mark. Oh, they covered that. They covered this. They're only going to cover each topic maybe once or twice, so you can kind of check it off your list. So the circular motion is checked off. Now they go into waves. So you can go through some entry level wave stuff. This is diffraction, some conceptual wave stuff. So you can check it off your list. Then they go into energy production and a little bit of quantum mechanics. And then they go into a little bit of electricity. They haven't covered electricity yet in this paper, so oh no, this is energy production yet. Oh, sorry, my bad. Now this is electricity, entry level electricity. So they haven't covered that yet. Then it goes into higher level particle physics because they covered particle physics up here. This is going to be higher level stuff. So the way to do well on this paper is to kind of go through the check, like make a check mark on each topic that they cover, and they're going to cover the standard level stuff first and then the higher level stuff later. This takes a lot of practice, so we're going to do some practice with this paper and navigating through this formula packet. So on to paper three.